Contradictory statements given by two Philippine government agencies regarding documents for the operation of the sunken tanker that caused the oil spill in Orientan, Mindoro. Maritime authorities also flagged discrepancies in the ship's certificate of registration. Delis Datu has details.
During a Senate hearing on Tuesday, the Maritime Industry Authority or Marina revealed that the sunken MT Princess Empress lacks a certificate of public convenience, which should have prevented it from sailing last February 27. But right after the hearing, the Philippine Coast Guard released documents that showed the vessel had valid documents. In an interview with Teleradio, Marina argued that while the ship owner RDC Real Marine Services Incorporated has a valid CPC, it failed to secure a temporary permit to operate MT Princess Empress. An application for the permit is still pending since the marine vessel was only bought in 2022.
Kasama po sa proseso ng bago po mag-operate po ang isa pong bagong barko, i-add po yan sa kanyang fleet o sa kanya pong CPC. Hindi pa po na-i-add ito pong tanker Princess Empress doon po sa CPC ng kumpanya.
The Philippine Coast Guard, however, stressed the second mate of MT Princess Empress provided them with 6 copies of CPC before the vessel set sail on February 27. The CPC showed that MT Princess Empress has been officially added to the fleet of the company. These documents were also shown to the PCG during its trips to Manila, Cebu, Misamis Oriental, and Iloilo. But because of the statement of Marina, the Philippine Coast Guard says it will start an investigation.
Kami yung naipit kasi parang lumalabas walang CPC. Pero in truth, merong sinasubmit sa amin at yun nga yung pinangahawakan namin. Kung ito may later on mapatunayan yung spurious, di dapat pananagutin natin yung nagbigay ng document.
The Philippine Coast Guard will also check if each boarding team inspected the vessel. They will also verify inconsistencies in the certificate of registration of the motor tanker. It was revealed that the MT Princess Empress was already registered in 2020 before it was even built 2 years later. While the authorities are resolving the issue on the CPC, several towns in Oriental Mindoro continue to suffer from the oil spill. Earlier, the disaster relief team from Japan Coast Guard showed Polar residents how to use an oil snail to effectively remove oil deposits from the shore.
Meron dalawang oil na pwedeng i-prevent para hindi madumihan yung seashore natin. Yung isa, yung malapot na parang honey. Yung malapot na parang honey, kapag lumulutang parating po dito at nilagay po yun, doon mapiprevent po yung ganong oil.
A remotely operated vehicle or ROV is expected to arrive in the province on Monday. The ROV has the capability to reach the sunken ship from the depths of the sea. It can also detect if there are holes from MT Princess Empress. Moreover, it can seal these holes to prevent its cargo of 800,000 liters of industrial oil from leaking. The Pola LGU also recorded at least 164 residents who got sick due to the oil spill. According to NDRRMC, at least 31,000 families and 13,000 farmers and fisher folks have been affected by the oil spill in Mimaropa and Western Visayas. Dennis Datu, ABS-CBN News, Oriental Mindoro.
The Bureau of Immigration again warning Filipinos over call center scams abroad that have victimized aspiring overseas workers. This comes after a Filipino woman was repatriated from Thailand on March 9 after she fell prey to a trafficking scam in Myanmar. The Bureau says the woman was recruited through Facebook to work in a call center in Thailand. The victim was told to pose as a tourist there, but was reportedly fetched by a private car and traveled 12 hours until reaching Myanmar. The victim was reportedly forced to work long hours without a day off while being required to pay for her release. The woman sought help from the Philippine Embassy in Bangkok, which led to her repatriation.
Sectoral groups calling on the Philippine government to focus on addressing pressing concerns instead of focusing on amending the 1987 Constitution. They issued that appeal in a protest Wednesday to mark World Consumer Rights Day. Former lawmaker Attorney Nery Colmenares reiterated his support for a bill seeking a 750 peso increase in the daily minimum wage of workers in the private sector.
Gusto nilang sumayaw tayo ng tsa-tsa sa gitna ng gutom, sa gitna ng kababaan ng sahod, kawalan ng trabaho, sa gitna ng mataas na presyo ng bilihin, gusto nila sumayaw pa rin tayo ng tsa-tsa.
The Philippine Transportation Department is planning to give fare discounts to commuters. This will be done through a service contracting program. Under that program, government will shoulder the amount that will be deducted to the original fares implemented by public utility vehicles. The program's budget is pegged at 1.2 billion pesos.
Tinatantya na baka paabotin natin ito ng mga 6 months. Ang diskwento ay doon sa level ng bago magpandemya. So this means ang magiging minimum fare sa jeep ay 9 pesos. Hindi pa kaagad masimulan kasi hinihintay yung pondo. So ang pondo will come from DBM